Thanks to YouTube for supporting PBS Digital Studios.
Recommendations.
Looks like you're saying graham crackers.
Hey, I'm Dianna, and you're watching Physics Girl. 6 years ago, I started this YouTube channel with a video about what to do with a physics degree. But the dirty truth is that I was leaving a job at the time working in physics at Harvard studying low metallicity stars, which are the oldest stars in the universe and don't have very many heavy metals because there were no supernovas yet to make heavy metals. But I digress. And I was starting a job at General Electric making iPad apps working as a software engineer. So why did I leave physics? To be honest, when I was working the research job, the thing that I had liked most about it was the coding part, because that was the most problem-solving-y, creative puzzle part. And the only thing I like more than a puzzle is a board game.
You can't take that home, Dianna.
So why is a woman who runs a channel called Physics Girl making a video about software engineering? Well, because that's where the jobs are. I often think about going back to software engineering. So recently, I went to interview some of the top engineering leads at YouTube to figure out what my software career could have been like. What it could still be like?
Do you sit in a basement?
No.
Do you fix computers?
No, except at my house.
Do you have to work alone to work best?
These are hilarious.
Okay, yeah. That's all I needed to know. Thank you, we're done.
These are the misconceptions about software engineers. So let's just get them all out of the way. So what is it that really makes these people passionate about writing code?
Freshman year, I didn't know what a computer programming language was. Took my first computer programming language course, and everything else had been about memorization, right? You memorize a bunch of stuff and then right. You regurgitate it. But this for me wasn't about memorization, and for the first time I was like, wow, this is like I'm solving puzzles.
Yeah, that's what it is. You're solving puzzles. Imagine that you're writing a New York Times bestselling book called The Martian, and you have to figure out how long it's gonna take your ion drive to take you from Earth to Mars and back. Now, you could write down your set of constraints on a piece of paper, like gravity exists and Earth has this much of it, and then take those constraints and write down all your instructions, like leave with your ion drive at this velocity going in this direction, and then solve the equation on paper. But it would take a really long time. You can do the same thing on a computer, write your constraints and write your instructions, and you have a computer program, and the computer can solve it a whole lot faster than you can. And you can just get as complicated as you want with computer programs, like writing anything in virtual reality.
There was a virtual reality programming class. Mm-hmm. That was when, for the very first time, I learned about 3D graphic rendering, mm-hmm. and could sort of create these objects in space. This technology was becoming more consumer friendly. That's when I realized this now is probably the right time for VR. Now's a good time.
Virtual reality is coming. Granted, I've only ever used VR goggles to fly in an indoor skydiving tunnel to see the video of somebody else skydiving, and in the zero-G plane to see space while I was floating in microgravity. Not to brag or anything about my VR experiences, but the point is, somebody coded all of that. Ben, can I film you?
So you work with Jacob Collier.
Yeah,
he's a double Grammy winning musician, and you toured him.
That's true.
Yeah, and so what software did you make for him?
So the software that we use with him is the thing that allows him to multiply his voice. He sings one note and then he can play lots of extra notes, but instead of the notes coming out like a piano, it's extra copies of his voice. You get like a choir on the spot.
And so you wrote that.
Yeah, well, it's a lot of different things that we had to get to work together. And yeah. So a lot of what I wrote for that was actually, we call it glue code, which glues a lot of things together so that they all work. You can make up to 12 note harmonies.
Oh my God.
All at once.
Software is everything. So how does one get into software engineering?
My mom had been taking programming. She also taught me BASIC. I made this program that would draw this green alligator because the alligator was green. My babysitter came over because my parents were going out, and she said, oh, could you make the alligator red?
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, she wants something from me, but I want something from her. I want to stay up till 9 o'clock so I can watch The Love Boat. And that was past my bedtime, right? And so I said, well, if I make the alligator red, will you let me stay up to watch The Love Boat? And she was like, okay. This is like Peter. This programming thing is the best thing since sliced bread.
So basically, get it? Basically, basic, get it? No. You start with a problem that you want to solve. Could be anything. No, like right now, think about what problem you have. I bet you can think of a program or an app that can solve that problem. Okay, next in the interviews, I wanted to ask the women what got them so passionate about what they do.
What gets you excited
about VR? At the tip top of the list is the power that immersion has in terms of life. One of the things I'm passionate about socially, specifically being a woman, being a Black woman in this environment, is around diversity, inclusion, but what drives that is empathy and compassion. Right? And so how can I be more inclusive if I can't really understand or empathize what it's like to be the only one in a room? So it's like, you know, you can't really give someone a pill, right? Like, hey, take this pill and now empathize with my experience, right? Like, you can't really do that.
But you can put on VR goggles and know what it's like to be someone who owns the greatest game ever made.
I'm going to play another woodcutter.
Plus, you have something concrete by the time you're finished making a program, something that can be applicable to the real world.
So if you look at pure math, which I was very good at, but I never really felt for it because what do all these numbers mean? What do they mean, right? Like, I feel software.
When am I gonna use this?
But with software, you are taking math and you are making it something concrete. For example, when I edit these videos, I can do some kind of blend of two different images. And if you've ever used Photoshop or video editors, you've done this before. There are a bunch of different blend options. And what those are literally doing is they are taking individual pixels and storing them as numbers. And then, for example, if you're using the add blend, you are adding the numbers. You're literally doing math. So people who have done this a lot, they just have an intuition for what the different names like add, lighten, color dodge, linear dodge, overlay, screen, difference, exclusion. But what's actually going on is you are doing math to the pixels of the two pictures and using some kind of formula to combine them and give you numbers for the pixels of your new picture. Math to application, they're in the software. So I hope this gives some small insight into why I liked software engineering so much, clears up some of the misconceptions about what it's like to be a software engineer. And lastly, since I was talking to some engineers at YouTube, I wanted to let them know that they had made this incredible platform that gave a place for cat videos and ridiculous vlog challenges. So I made them do a challenge with me, the whisper challenge. The idea is you put on headphones and it's playing really loud music and then someone else whispers a term and you have to try to guess what they're saying. So I want to show you how that went with the engineers, but first, I'd like to thank YouTube Careers for supporting me in this video and supporting PBS Digital Studios. YouTube is working on projects across the landscape of media, music, and technology, and there are opportunities for people with a passion for media and technology to help make a difference. To learn more about the career possibilities available at YouTube, visit this link. And happy physicsing.
Singularity.
Engineering.
No.
String theory?
Really close though.
Entropy.
Entropy!
Oh, yeah!
Joules law.
Too slow?
No.
I look like an engineer.
I like it here?
Heuristic.
Statistics?
What was it? It was heuristic.
Oh!
Yeah.
Recommendations.
It looks like you're saying graham crackers.
I was saying recommendations.
I have no idea. No idea.
Recommendations.
Model-driven architecture.
Parts of the nation.
I have no idea. Quick sort and heap sort.
Oh,
I'm so glad I'm doing the talking here.
Question and rescue.
Quick sort and heap sort.
Well, that's so cute.